Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel Genius Speaking, where I teach Italian language, but I also spread Italian culture. That's why I started this series about Dante and his Divine Comedy, because it is one of the most fundamental masterpieces of Italian literature. I hope you enjoyed knowing more about the epic journey of Dante and Virgilio, so buckle up and welcome back to Hell. So in the previous episode, we left Dante and Virgilio coming across the river Acheron. It is the river that, from ancient mythology, separates the world of the living and the world of the dead. In Acheron River, there is the figure of Charon, who is ferrying the souls of the damned from Ante-Inferno to Hell. He is a figure belonging to the pagan mythology. Son of Erebus and Nai, he is traditionally the person that transports the souls of the deceased people through his boats across the Acheron River, allowing the souls to reach their eternal punishments. Ed ecco verso noi venir per nave un vecchio bianco per antico pelo, gridando, guai a voi anime prave, non isperate mai a vederlo cielo. I vengo per menarvi all'altra riva, nelle tenebre eterne, in caldo e in gelo. E tu, che sei costì anima viva, partiti da cotesti che son morti. Ma poi, che vide che non mi partiva? Disse, per altra via, per altri porti verrai a piaggia, non qui per passare. Più leve legno convien che ti porti. In these verses, Dante describes the figure of Charon. Un vecchio bianco per antico pelo, un vecchio old man. Bianco, white hair, per antico pelo. Pelo is hair, antico is old. So he's describing an old man with gray hair, but Dante tells more, tells that Charon is yelling to souls. Guai a voi, anime prave. Non isperate mai a vederlo cielo. Beware, lost souls. Don't even hope, mai, never, a vederlo cielo, to see the sky. So from now to eternity, you won't be capable to see sky anymore. I vegno per menare all'altra riva. I'm coming to io vegno. It is old age for io vengo, I come, to bring you to the other side. Nelle tenebre eterne, in caldo e in gelo, so in the eternal darkness, tenebre eterne, in caldo, in hot and cold, in gelo, because Dante's hell is also cold. And after Charon spots Dante, and he tells him, e tu che sei costì anima viva, so you that are a living soul, so Charon spots that Dante is not dead, partiti da cotesti che sono morti, get away, partiti, da codesti, from these ones, che sono morti, that are dead. Ma poi vide che io non mi partiva, but Charon saw that I wasn't moving. And so he says, disse, per altra via, per altri porti, verrai a piaggia. So Charon tells Dante that he must undergo another path, once that dead souls cannot cross. Only him, only Dante is capable to do this journey. But the question is, why in the Divine Comedy there's a character that belongs to pagan mythology? Well, we think that Dante uses the character of Charon to pay another tribute to Virgilio, because Virgilio is one of the first to write about Charon in the sixth book of Aeneid, when Aeneas is about to descend in hell. In fact, Dante's description of Charon is widely taken from the Virgilio version of Charon, a white-haired old man with fiery eyes. Narrative-wise, Charon, also to pay tribute to Virgilio, foresees the salvation of Dante's soul. In fact, Charon tells Dante that he's going to take a different path, from purgatory to heavens, where there awaits Dante's salvation. But while they're waiting for the two to cross the river, there's an earthquake. Dante faints, and once he regains his senses, he finds himself in the other side of the Acheron River. Well, that could be a plot hole or, you know, a way to just simply get away with the matter of fact that Dante is not dead, so he cannot technically travel the Acheron River. So somehow Dante managed to get transport on the other side without telling to readers how that's possible. Finito questo, la buia campagna tremò sì forte che dello spavento la mente di sudore ancora in bagno. La buia campagna tremò sì forte. Tremò, trembling, so it describes the earth, that is, trembling, so the earthquake, che dello spavento la mente di sudore ancora mi bagna. So, from the matter of fact, I was scared. La mente, the forehead is still covered in sweats. Di sudor, sweat, ancora mi bagna. It is wet of. La terra lagrimosa diede vento, che balenò una luce vermiglia, la quale mi vinse ciascun sentimento, e caddi come l'uom cui sonno piglia. Balenò una luce vermiglia, so, lights, just in front of my eyes, vermiglia, color vermilion, la qual mi vinse ciascun sentimento. That vermilion light was so strong that one vinse every feeling, ogni sentimento. So, the light wins over the consciousness. So, Dante caddi, fell, come l'uomo in cui sonno piglia, like man that falls into slumber, sonno, slumber, piglia, is taken from. Ladies and gentlemen, the literature Italian literature class is over for today. If you like my work, especially the work I'm doing, bringing to you the Divine Comedy, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. But most importantly, remember, speak like a genius. Bye.